Good morning, everybody. Today I am going to give a discussion on semiconductors. Before going to the semiconductor discussion, let me give an introduction to materials. There are three important types of materials. They are conductors, insulators, and semiconductors. Conductors are the one which can conduct electricity very well. The best example is copper. Insulators are poor conductors of electricity. The examples are wood and plastic. Semiconductors will have a partial behavior between the conductor and the insulator. The best examples of semiconductors are germanium and silicon. The effect of semiconductor was experimentally verified by Michael Faraday. There are two important types of semiconductors. Otherwise, the semiconductors are being classified into two important types. They are intrinsic semiconductors and extrinsic semiconductors. Intrinsic semiconductors are the purest form of semiconductors, whereas the extrinsic semiconductors are the impure form of semiconductors. Let us consider the intrinsic semiconductor type now. The examples are silicon and germanium. Let us consider the silicon semiconductor material. Each silicon atom will have 4 electrons in its outermost shell. To form a strong bond, it needs at least 8 electrons in the outermost shell. That is, to become more stable, at least there must be 8 electrons in the outermost shell of a silicon. So each silicon, there are n number of silicon atoms which are arranged in a fashion. So each silicon atom combines with another electron from the neighboring silicon atom and forms a pair. So that pair is called as covalent bond. This covalent bond is usually very strong at 0 Kelvin. When the temperature slowly increases, the bond tries to break up. So one electron from the silicon atom tries to move and it creates a hole. Similarly, each covalent bond tries to break up as the temperature increases. When the covalent bond breaks up, the electron becomes free and it tries to carry the current. So there is a deficiency of electron. So a hole is created and that hole is known as positively charged particle, whereas the electron is said to be negatively charged particle. This process is repeated for the whole structure, and the electron deficiency will be happening when the covalent bond tries to break, and that creates a positive charge once again in the entire structure, and the process repeats. Let us now discuss about extrinsic semiconductors. Extrinsic semiconductors are the impure form of semiconductors. The extrinsic semiconductors are usually formed from the intrinsic semiconductors by adding the impurities. The impurities usually added to the intrinsic semiconductors to make the extrinsic semiconductors are called dopants. And the process of adding the impurities to the intrinsic semiconductors to make the extrinsic semiconductors is called doping. There are two types of extrinsic semiconductors. One is p-type or trivalent, and the other one is n-type or pentavalent. That is, trivalent impurities are added to form a p-type extrinsic semiconductor and pentavalent impurities are added to form n-type extrinsic semiconductor. Let us now see how the p-type extrinsic semiconductors are being formed by adding trivalent impurities. The best examples of trivalent impurities are boron, gallium and indium. Let us see now how a p-type extrinsic semiconductor could be formed. Let us say a trivalent boron impurity is being added to form a p-type extrinsic semiconductor. We know that each silicon atom will have 4 electrons in its outermost shell. When a boron impurity is being added to a silicon atom to form a p-type extrinsic semiconductor, the 3 electrons which are present in the boron outermost shell will be paired up with 3 electrons which are present in the silicon atom's outermost shell. This free electron which is available will try to attract the electrons from the neighboring silicon atom, which results in a creation of a hole, and that is why this type of extrinsic semiconductor is known as p-type extrinsic semiconductor. And the next one is formation of n-type extrinsic semiconductor. The impurities usually added for forming an n-type extrinsic semiconductors or antimony, phosphorus, etc. Let us say when phosphorus is being added to form an n-type extrinsic semiconductor, it has got 5 free electrons in its outermost shell. So it tries to form a covalent bond with the 4 electrons which are present already in the silicon atom. There is one electron which is left empty, which is free, and it is negatively charged. So there is one negatively charged particle which is completely available, which tries to circulate around the phosphorus atom. That is why this type of semiconductor is known as n-type extrinsic semiconductor. Today we have discussed about the types of materials, then about the semiconductors, types of semiconductors, and the formation of extrinsic semiconductors, that is p-type and n-type semiconductors. We'll see the rest in the next video. Thank you.